Today we are going to start with a new topic. Name of the topic is clariflocculator. So on the screen you can see, students, that there are two clariflocculators. One at the back, it is completely empty, and the one which is in the front is completely full with water. Okay, so let me explain you with the help of a clear diagram. So this is a clear picture of a clariflocculator. You can see over here the water will be filled into the clariflocculator using a influent pipe, right? Influent pipe is located at the center. Okay, this is the influent pipe, right? Next is the flocculator tank, right? So the cylindrical tank which you can see here, right, is the flocculator tank, right? So this is the flocculator, right? Here this is the bridge on which the persons can move for inspection, right? Here there is a motor. Okay, motor is connected with shaft. Okay, then shaft is connected with paddles, right? So whatever the water is coming out of the flash mixture is the mixture of water and coagulant, right? So in flocculator what happens is, once the flow of water has started, the water will come out of the flocculator and it will enter this particular space. This space is known as clarifier. Okay, the outer space is known as clarifier. You can see this is the partition wall, right? This is the partition wall. Okay, so the water will enter the clarifier from below the partition wall. Okay, so these are the openings you can see, right? This is the opening, this is the opening. So there will be opening all around the flocculator, okay, below the partition wall. Okay, now the flocs that are being produced in the flocculator will settle after capturing the suspended solids, right? And these flocs will settle at the bottom of the clarifier here. Okay, now there is a slope at the bottom of the clarifier. So this is at a higher elevation. Okay, and the center portion is at a lower elevation. Okay, fine. So what happens is, when this scraper is moving, right, and these blades will be also moving, so these blades will push all the flocs or the suspended solids towards the center. Okay, and as a result the suspended solids will be removed and clear water will be obtained. Now the clear water will be removed from the top of the clariflocculator, right? So after the water is purified, the water will enter this channel. This channel is known as effluent channel. Okay, this channel is known as effluent channel, and from here the water is sent to the rapid sand filter. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. Let us move ahead. So this is the plan of the clariflocculator. This is the influent pipe. Okay, now at the center there is a gap between the influent pipe and the bottom of the clariflocculator. Okay, there is a gap between the influent pipe and the bottom of the clariflocculator, from which the all the sludge that is deposited will be removed. Okay, so this is the pipe, right? Pipe for removal of sludge. Okay, Clear? So can you guess what is this? This is the flocculator. Right? And this is the clarifier. This is effluent channel. Right? And this is outlet pipe. Okay? Clear? And this you can see is the blades. Clear? So let us have a look at the section. Okay? So you can see over here, this is the bridge. Okay? This is the outer layer or the outer wall, that is the clarifier wall. Right? This here is the PCC. Fine? And slope is provided of 1:12. Right? This is the inlet pipe. Okay? This is here. As I said, that there is a gap between the bottom. This is the bottom, right? And the influent pipe. So this gap is used for collecting the sludge. Okay, so I'll write here desludging pipe. Okay, this is electric conduit for cabling purpose. Okay, here the purified water will be coming out, so this will act as a weir. Okay, this is the effluent channel. So I'll write here, this is the width of effluent channel. Okay, this is the effluent channel. Fine. Now you can see over here that this arrow, can you guess what is this? This is the diameter of flocculator DF. And can you guess what is this? This arrow represents is the diameter of clarifier, that is DCR. Okay, so this is asked in the exam, that draw the cross section of the clariflocculator and label it. Okay, so let us have a look at the design steps of the clariflocculator. Okay, so step one is design of influent pipe. So influent pipe is located at the center. Okay, so here you can see this particular structure is the influent pipe. Okay, you can see that this is the structure of influent pipe and this is the bottom. So here, right here, all the sludge will be deposited, and from below this portion there is a desludging pipe provided. Okay, so from which the sludge will be removed. Clear? So let us have a look at another one, that is step 2. So step 2 I have divided into 3 parts. Okay, that is step 2A, step 2B and step 2C, right? Because all of those 3 sub steps deals with design of the flocculator itself. Okay, so the first sub step, that is step 2A, deals with design of flocculator diameter. Okay, so I'll show you this. So this is the under construction clariflocculator. So you can see that this red line represents the diameter. Okay, diameter of the flocculator. Clear? So that will be our step number 2A. Okay, then step 2B, which is design of paddles. Okay, so here you can see, right, these are the paddles, so we need to design those paddles as well. Fine. Next is step 2C, that is design of partition wall and depth of the flocculator. Okay, so this is the partition wall, right? This is partition wall and this is the depth. Understood, students? Okay, So we need to design this also. Fine. Next step, that is step 3, that will be design of a clarifier. So we need to design this diameter. Okay, so from here to on the other side here, right? So the diameter of the clarifier, clear? And the last step, that is design of the effluent channel. Okay, so this one, right? So that water will be coming out of the clarifloculator and it will be supplied to rabbits and filter via effluent channel. Clear? I hope these steps are clear to you. Fine. So let us have a look at the design example. Okay, so the question says that design a clarifloculator for treating 250 meter cube per hour of flow of water. Okay, so let us start with the first step, that is the design of influent pipe. Okay, so once again I'll show you, we need to design this, that is the influent pipe. Clear? Okay, so as we are not given any kind of data, we will need to assume some data, right? So the first assumption will be velocity of flow through the pipe, and that is usually taken as 0.8 meter per second. Okay, then we need to find out area from the relation Q equals to AV. Q we are already given, that is 250 meter cube per hour. Okay, velocity we have assumed, so we can find out area, and from the area we can find out the diameter. Easy step. Okay, so let us start. Okay, so since Q is given as 250 meter cube per hour, we will assume 0.8 meter per second as the velocity. So next is find out the area, that is A equals to Q by V. Okay, so since 250 meter cube per hour is there, I'll have to convert this hour into seconds. Okay, so for converting hour into seconds, we need to multiply 1 hour equals to 60 minutes and 1 minute equals to 60 seconds. Okay, so I have to multiply this with 60 into 60, right? Since R is in denominator, I'll have to multiply 60 into 60 in the denominator. Okay, so 250 divided by 0.8, that is meter per second, into 60 into 60, and this comes out to be equals to 0.087 meter square. Okay, now we know that area equals to pi by 4 d square, right? Since we need to find out the diameter of the pipe, I have written as dp square. Therefore dp equals to under root of 0.087 into 4 by pi, that is equals to 0.33. since there is no pipe available of 0.33 diameter, we will need to round off. So provide influent pipe of 0.35 meter diameter. Clear? So this is step number 1. I hope this step you have understood. Okay.